was her first album, my first album, and I was, oh, we were all doing, there was a songwriter named Linda Creed out of Philadelphia, and it was a tribute to Linda Creed. I opened, what's her name, Jean Karn, Norman Connors, a whole bunch, because it was a lot of Philly-based singers, some from that side. So it was time for the finale. Everybody was so excited to be on this stage with this newcomer, Whitney Houston. Well, first of all, they were all trying to out-sing each other. Whitney was like appalled that they were doing that. She was ignoring them. I couldn't sing because I was so busy going, oh my God, oh my God. So this many years later, I would see Whitney, you know, out and about or whatever, and by this time she's Whitney. So all you get a chance to do is just, you know, glance and wave and say hello. So 3 days before she left, they were celebrating, no, about 5 days, celebrating Ray J's birthday at the Beverly Hills Hotel. Just sitting at the bar, low-key, she was having tea. She was looking wonderful. She sounded wonderful. It was Kim Whitley and I. And I walked over, told him, you know, happy birthday, whatever. And she said, you don't think that I remember that she was gawking at me and you couldn't even sing your song because you were paying attention to me. That touched me because we're talking 25 years ago. You know, and she was that type of person. If you made that much of an impression on her, she remembered you by name and instance.